So, what is game composition and how do we use it? Game composition is all about how the game presents itself to the player. This video is going to be very lengthy, so splitting it up into three parts makes the most sense. So this video will be based on overall aspects of your game, such as objectives, characters, and leading the player in unnuanced ways. So, let's talk about objectives. Objectives are essentially goals in your game. These are what your players are aiming towards and the de facto win or loss conditions. Now, I could list a load of different objective tropes, but that would make the video last much longer than needed. So instead, I'm going to help you understand what type of objectives you should place into a game to keep the feeling and immersion within your game intentionally set to the progression you create. To begin with, let's talk about the theory behind objectives. Objectives are there to lead your player towards either the end of your game or to help the story last longer in side quests, leading to more progression for the character. These objectives also come with a flip side, a reward. Rewards are extremely important to get right. For instance, if a side objective lasts several quests long, leading the player across the map and fighting multiple enemies, they will want a reward that is equal or better to the work they've put in to get there. Leaving without a reward, or at least a fulfilling one, can leave the player frustrated and lead to less playtime on your game, and by extension, a dissatisfying game. You want to help the player by giving them enough equipment and skills to face your game's difficulty level. Not balancing this can lead to an extremely unplayable game. Do not force your players to do the side quests. Unfortunately, players don't like it when you throw similar boring quests in their face with no way around it. Side quests are meant to be enjoyed at the discretion of the player, and if forced, they are going to enjoy it. Be fun and creative. Don't make a bunch of fetch quests. That was acceptable in the 2000s. Not anymore. If you're creating an RPG, try to think of better and fun ways to drive your player to the next storyline. Remember, not all objectives need to be shoved down the face of the player. The game needs to be somewhat intuitive to be fun, so using sound, visuals and mechanics such as footsteps approaching the chase sequence, dirt masks to signify the player when they've done something wrong, and hot tips with a bandage icon when your character is wounded. All objectives should push the player forward. Don't make a scene where the player gets chased backwards or the storyline leads back to the same conclusion as before. Finally, the game needs to follow exactly what emotions you're trying to manipulate. If you're trying to scare the player or get them to run, place a chase sequence. If you want them to sneak around, place a sneaking sequence. This is all unnuanced and you should be able to fit certain objectives within every aspect of your game intuitively and creatively to have a successful project. NPCs, or non-playable characters, are generally either very overlooked or the main aspect of the game. By that, I mean they either play no part in the game, or they are the main factors. I like to think we can start creating interesting side characters with a decent amount of story without overloading or underloading them with noise. Games like Life is Strange does this perfectly. I was really quite interested in each character, but they were perfectly placed both in story and in gameplay. Your main character should be your main driving force of your narrative. Well, unless it's in exceptional circumstances. This means that a hierarchy of importance for characters needs to be in place with screen time and interactivity. This doesn't have to be a physical list. It just means you need an idea of how much time you want to give your characters from most to least interesting. Enemies need to be interesting. Of course, in a horror game, the enemy needs to be both visually interesting and based within the storyline in an interesting way. For instance, there could be an interesting dynamic between the main character and the enemy. Think about narrative twists. Your main character could have lost a loved one, and that enemy is that person. There's a lot you could do, so think as far outside the box and really try to surprise the player with a satisfying reveal. Your protagonist needs to be the centre point of your game. Now, it doesn't matter if you show a backstory or the story fills in the gaps, they just need to be relatively interesting. For example, in the movie Drive, the main character has never mentioned his name, nor does anyone in the movie. He has no backstory, yet his persona and charisma make his character insanely intricate. The next video will focus on world building and narrative loops. I hope you enjoyed, and have a great day.